do you know, Emma? China has officially announced the construction of the world's first fusion-fission hybrid nuclear reactor in Jiangxi province. The Xinghuo Reactor. It's a monumental leap for global energy innovation. It's a bridge between the aging reality of nuclear fission and the long-promised dream of nuclear fusion.
Yeah, it is, Charlie. That's really a huge move. So nuclear fusion reactor is not just theoretical anymore. This is real infrastructure being planned. It's like seeing the future finally stepping into the present. I think it reflects a growing urgency to rethink how we produce energy on a massive scale.
At the heart of this development lies the combination of two fundamentally different nuclear processes. Fission and fusion. Two different paths to energy generation. Nuclear fission is the process that powers every existing nuclear reactor today. Nuclear fission is a reaction in which the nucleus of a heavy atom splits into two or more smaller nuclei. Along with the release of a large amount of energy, neutrons, and radiation.
Nuclear fission is a mature and well-understood technology, but it produces long-lived radioactive waste and carries inherent risks of chain reaction meltdown, like the disasters at Chernobyl and Fukushima.
Fusion, on the other hand, is the reaction that powers the sun. It involves merging light nuclei, usually hydrogen isotopes like deuterium and tritium. This happens under extreme temperatures and pressures. The nuclei form heavier atoms and release immense energy. Unlike fission, fusion produces very little radioactive waste. It also carries no risk of chain reaction meltdowns. The main challenge is creating and maintaining the ultra-high energy conditions needed for controlled, continuous fusion.
Fusion is the holy grail of clean energy. It offers limitless fuel, minimal waste, and much greater safety. But the physics is tough. We've spent decades trying to bottle a star. That's what makes the hybrid concept so clever. It uses fusion not just for power, but to make fission safer and cleaner. It's a layered solution to a complex problem.
The Xinghuo reactor is being developed on Yahoo Science Island in Nanchang. It takes a hybrid approach to solving key energy challenges. A fusion core will act as a strong neutron source. These neutrons will trigger fission in a blanket of fertile materials, like thorium-232 or depleted uranium. This setup boosts energy output and helps convert long-lived nuclear waste into usable fuel.
If it works, the design could be a practical stepping stone toward fusion power and a partial remedy to the long-standing issue of nuclear waste accumulation. I love that. It's not just efficient, it's poetic in a way. And thorium, that's a really promising element we don't hear enough about. It's more abundant and less weaponizable than uranium, so it ticks both environmental and geopolitical boxes. This kind of closed-loop thinking could reshape how we look at nuclear energy today.
You know, Emma. Project officials say the reactor aims to generate 100 megawatts of electricity. The design work should finish by 2025, and full operation is expected by 2031. By the way, one key goal is to reach a Q value over 30.
Wow, Q value over 30? And that means it would produce 30 times more energy than it consumes. It would surpass all existing fusion experiments. So this isn't just ambitious, and it's next level.
Chinese scientists call the project more than just an energy effort. They see it as a strategic national priority. It has backing from the Chinese Academy of Engineering Physics and other major research institutions. The reactor will also be a testbed. It will help develop new materials, control systems, and waste reprocessing methods. This work could lay the foundation for future clean nuclear energy.
That phrase, strategic national priority, says a lot. This isn't just about powering cities, it's about long-term energy dominance and technological leadership. And the testbed angle is important too. This could be the RD hub for the next few decades of nuclear innovation.
Perhaps the most promising aspect of fusion is safety. The fusion-fission hybrid concept leverages this advantage. They still use fissionable materials, but the initiating fusion core contributes to a safer and more controllable overall system.
I agree, Charlie. Safety is a major selling point. Public trust in nuclear dropped after past disasters, and understandably so. But a model that's meltdown-proof and cuts long-term waste, that's more than just a better reactor. That's a public relation reset for nuclear energy, a clear effort to change how nuclear energy is perceived by the public, media, and policymakers.
Globally, fusion research has faced many challenges. These include technical setbacks, budget overruns, and missed deadlines. China's move to build a hybrid reactor shows a different approach. It recognizes fusion's potential and fission's limits. Instead of waiting for full fusion power, the Xinghuo reactor takes a middle path. It's grounded in current technology, mindful of the environment, and focused on the future.
I really admire that pragmatism. It's easy to get caught up in utopian visions and lose sight of what's achievable now. This hybrid strategy feels like a bridge we can actually walk on and not just dream about.
Totally. As the world wrestles with the twin challenges of energy security and climate change, China's fusion-fission hybrid could be a transformative solution. If Xinghuo succeeds, it won't just power homes, it could illuminate a new direction for global energy policy and technological cooperation. It could be one of the defining tech milestones of the 21st century.